Good morning, mother. Oh. Good morning, people. And today is the day I hit 1,000 subscribers. Woohoo! Yeah, so today is the day that I hit 1,000 subscribers thanks to my 1,000th subscriber, which was Joseph. Joseph, you're a star. You were the person to click that button for the 1,000th time. That is pretty cool, I think. Let's fill up before we get cracking into this video. And if any of you are wondering, yes, that is a service light. It is on. But as you know, there's lots of work that's been done to this bike already, so all it needs is an oil change. And this is a new phone holder. It's the quad lock. Today is actually Black Friday. It's a very good time to buy one because it's 30% off. I want you guys to see this video and think how to ride safely, because I really don't want you guys to mess up and crash. It's bound to happen to all of us. We're on two wheels. Don't get on two wheels if you're not prepared to come off. Make sure you wear enough safety gear. This is my new RST jacket that I bought at the NEC. I'm going to give you tips, my tips, what I think you should do in order to stay safe. They are my tips. They're the things that I do. So for those out there that might want to then start saying,
no, that's not right, you shouldn't be doing that,
then don't bother commenting, because you'll just piss me off. This video is based for those that are thinking about riding and a little bit scared about safety, which is a normal concern. Or it could be that you are riding at the moment and maybe you're not that experienced to know the things that I'm going to be telling you today. I'm going to stick to 5 specific points, otherwise I'm going to ramble on this video, because I don't stop talking. That's my biggest problem. All right, people. So, one thing that you got to understand is the bike. The bike is something that is going to get you around, and you have to respect the bike. Don't be overconfident that you know how to use the bike. And that is the problem with a lot of people. They get overconfident and they end up fucking up along the way. Get to know the bike. Get comfortable with sitting on the bike. Get comfortable balancing the bike. Get comfortable just pulling the bike and lifting it, putting it on its side stand, putting it on the center stand, you know, walking with the bike. Get used to the basics. Get comfortable with the basics. A big problem what many people do is they don't know how to do the basics, and they try and ride off expecting to know how to do it. That is a big problem. That's a big mistake. Don't make that mistake. Get used to the bike and get to know the bike before you even ride the bike properly. Don't think you've passed your test and everything is amazing and you know how to ride like Valentino Rossi, because it's not going to be the case. The next thing is you. What you're wearing. What you're wearing, your gear, it's important. Make sure you wear the right gear. So think about from top to toe what you need. All right, you're going to need some good shoes. I've decided to go with boots whilst using an adventure bike. And I used to use trainers. I was one of those idiots that would wear trainers, and I used to be very comfortable wearing trainers. And when I switched to boots, I found it very uncomfortable. I found them too big and I didn't feel the bike. Now, it is going to be very difficult for me to ride with trainers, because I'm so used to wearing boots and I feel so much more comfortable and more safe and more secure that I won't go back to trainers. Trousers, get some Kevlar jeans, textile, leathers, it is up to you. Leathers will withstand much tougher circumstances, which will be sliding on the floor. It is much stronger than textile. There's going to be a couple of you out there going,
no, that's wrong, textile is stronger, Gore-Tex is better, blah, blah, blah.
I'm not getting involved in that. You guys make the decision what you want to get, but get some good gear. Trousers and a jacket is a must. Another thing is armor. Don't mix yourself up with your trousers and your jackets and forgetting about armor. You want good, strong elbow armor, shoulder armor, back armor. You can get some good chest armor. I'm not wearing any today. Same with the trousers, knees. You can get shins. I've got long boots, so I'm okay there. You can get side panels as well. And there's a lot more that you can get, and you can go very much in detail. And of course, the more money you spend, the more you're going to get. Again, someone's going to say
it's not necessarily true.
Research your gear. Make sure you get enough gear. Helmet is going to be very important as well. So make sure you invest in a very good helmet. That's something I would highly recommend. Point number two that I want to talk about is road conditions. Road conditions is important, and especially at this time of year, as you can see by all of these leaves, how bad it is right now. And if I was to ride off thinking that this is going to be just as normal to ride off in, I'd be making a big mistake, because this rear wheel will skid all over these and I will be sliding. So the things you need to think about in road conditions are leaves, oil, manhole covers, also potholes, and any other sort of foreign debris that shouldn't be on the road. Don't assume the road is perfect, because they're not, especially in the UK. The road conditions here are awful. So please, look at where you're going. For those of you that didn't know, this is Alexandra Palace. This is where I used to go ice skating as a little kid. Yeah, believe it or not. You get some fantastic views here when the weather's not so crappy and shit as it is today. The weather's proper shit. Anyway, so let's talk about road positioning, because this is also very important. Is where you position yourself in the road, all right? And you are taught when you do your CBT that there's position one, which is where I am now. Position one is at the very end on the left-hand side of the road. Right, position one. Position two is in the middle of the road, like so. And position three would be on the far end. Right, if I am positioned here on position three all the time, I may have problems. If I am always in position two, I may also always have problems. If I am in position one, I can probably have a lot of problems. So, you need to decide when is the right time for you to be in which position. Alright, there's no special answer or simple answer to tell you that you must always stay in position two, because that's not true. That is not the case. You need to decide in which position is safest. That is it. Position one means that I am more likely to have people to want to overtake me, right? You can see clearly when I'm standing here. People are going to want to overtake me. Oh, can't even go right. Position two can be very good because you're in the middle. But at the same time, being in position two may not be as safe as being in position three. I ride mainly in position three most of the time, and that's for several reasons. Number one, sometimes in the middle of the road you can get a lot of debris because the cars pass over the debris in the center of their vehicles, especially trucks. So the wheels are touching on position one and three on a car, but we're driving in position two, which is not where a car's wheels touches. So that's why I ride in position three most of the time. And not only for that, there's another reason. I feel that being in position two gives the person a sense of understanding you're there, but in position three makes a car driver more aware that you are there, because they see you in your side mirror. And also think about a van. A van doesn't have a rear view mirror, or a lorry. So the only way they can see you is through their side mirrors. And if you can't see their side mirrors, chances are they cannot see you. But as I said, it's case by case. You have to assess the situation and decide what is best. You have to be careful of other people. They may not even be driving yet. They may be just getting out of the car. Right? Think about it. I'm in position one now. If anybody opens that door or this van, right, I'm stuffed. Any of them open their doors, I'm screwed. And this guy behind me wants to overtake me. Is overtaking. When you are overtaking people, you have to be very, very careful, because you have to always imagine as a biker that people have not seen you, because you are nowhere near the same size as a car. This is a big fucking bike, and it's orange, and it's loud as fuck, but still people will not see me. So you need to always imagine that people have not seen you. It's the best way of riding. Now, when it comes to overtaking, if I want to overtake this guy, one thing is I will make sure, first of all, I'm sticking to the speed limit on the road. Look at this guy now here. I'm in this position. He's undertaking me. So you see, I was in position three. He's turning left though, but still. He was undertaking me. Undertaking is illegal. Shouldn't do it. Coming up to the traffic light, I'm in position two. Why am I in position two? Because if I'm in position three and the person behind me wants to turn left, maybe they're going to try and squeeze in. And it's not worth it. So again, you know, it's all case by case. You just need to think a little bit of common sense, okay, and learn from your mistakes. Because it may be that you learn from your mistake. Maybe you go to position three and somebody does that and you think, why are they doing that? The reason they're doing it is because you've left them a gap. And in London, if there's a gap, people would attempt to go into it. Back to overtaking. Another thing that is really important is not to overtake at the wrong time. Of course, you need to stick to the limit, but if the person in front of you is going slowly and you want to overtake, you can overtake as long as it's safe to do so, okay? And there's no continuous single line. There's no zigzags, can't filter through zigzags, okay? And if you don't know any of these things, then you definitely need to learn the highway code. I've said this before in the last CBT video, and it is definitely worth you guys doing it. Definitely worth doing it. The most frustrating thing for me on the road is when people don't know the highway code. That is the most infuriating thing for me. When overtaking, if it is safe to do so and it is legal to do so, make sure you don't do it at the wrong time. For example, there's a turning coming up, right? This guy here is turning right. If I overtook him a little bit before and there was free, and it was free for him to go immediately, and he didn't indicate, I would hit him, or he would hit me, however you want to look at it. But there'd be an accident, and it would cause me to come off. I don't want to do that. So don't risk your life. Don't risk your life. Be careful. Don't overtake when there's a turning coming up. Very, very simple. Filtering. When it comes to filtering, you have to be very careful. It is legal to filter as long as it is safe to do so. Alright, but you have to know your bike, know your own skills, and don't exceed your skills. Don't think that you become overconfident. As I was explaining before, don't become overconfident with your bike. One big thing is to be aware of what is going on around you. A lot of people, they struggle with that. You should know what car is behind you, what car is behind that, and what is going on. So be aware of your surrounding areas. I know that I've got this Audi A8 behind me. I haven't seen any bikers for a little while, so I'm not expecting a biker to come up next to me. But nevertheless, I'm checking all the time. I'm checking my mirrors to make sure that there is nobody coming. That if I need to get out of a situation, I can. That if I need to do an emergency brake, I can. Whoa, like this guy. What the fuck is he doing? Idiot. Sticking out like that. You got to be careful. Be aware. Anticipate other road users. What they may do. That guy wasn't even looking at me. And he decided to just pull out that little bit further. And if I'm not aware that those things can happen, then it might scare me. And if it scares me, then I can make a very easy mistake on the bike and I can come off. Filtering is the last point that I really want to talk about. And it is legal to filter in the UK as long as it is safe to do so. You cannot filter on zebra crossings. You cannot filter between lanes when there's a continuous white line in the middle. All right, those things you should learn on the highway code. Anticipate what people might do. Okay, if you can squeeze through a gap, be careful that maybe the other person will do something stupid. Right, like this guy who just indicated and turned left at the same time. That is one of my biggest pet peeves. Really annoying. Guy here is going to turn right, look. Right, anticipate what they're going to do. Can you see? He didn't indicate, only when he moved into the lane already and then indicated. When it comes to filtering, you need to make sure that you stay safe and legal. But be careful. Be careful of people opening doors. Be careful of people randomly doing something. Be careful and always imagine people have not seen you. Okay? Right, let's imagine I want to filter the left-hand side. It would be stupid to filter the left because I could do it on the right. But just to show you, right? Here's a bus. Anyone might be trying to cross the road. So be careful of that. Here's another bus. Someone might walk in front of the bus. So you've got to be careful of that. When it comes to filtering, these are the things. If I want to go in the right lane now, check my right. I've seen the right before. Edge out slowly. Make sure it's all safe to do so and go for it. On the road, on the side roads, off the road, on the pedestrians, what the pedestrians are doing. I want to know every single thing that is going on. I will even go into the point that in London, private number plates are such a big thing that you're checking number plates. It's a normal thing to just check number plates and different cars and all these kind of things. Wow, that's a really nice Audi Q8. When did that come out? Holy moly. I want to see that. That looks sexy. Did you see that? All right, this is a stop sign, so I'm stopping legally. An Audi Q8. See the private number plate as well? This is so nice. That is gorgeous. Oh my God. I wouldn't mind getting one of those. That is one amazing looking machine. So there's an example of... Damn. There's an example of me looking at what's going on in my surrounding areas, okay? Or in the surrounding area. Okay, guys, if you've enjoyed watching this video and you thought that it was helpful, make sure you smash that like button. Let's see if we can get over 100 likes on this video. And my target for next year is 5,000 subscribers. I want to hit 5,000 subscribers by next year. This year, my target was to hit 1,000 by December. We're not even finishing off November and we've hit that, and I was nowhere near that target at the beginning of the year. So I really didn't expect that to actually happen. But because I stayed positive and focused, it happened and I made sure that it would work. Please make sure you subscribe if you haven't subscribed already, and make sure, just please make sure you share this video. Share it with your friends, share it with people you know who ride. Let's all stay safe on two wheels.